Hello students, I am Aniket Kirsch and today we will see some basic computer terminologies, right? When we talk about computer, some terms are very common. Okay, so first one is the hardware. What are all hardware, right? So the physical components of a computer, the physical parts of a computer are considered as a hardware devices. Getting? So, the physical components means what? The CPU, the main part one is the CPU. The CPU means central processing unit, the brain of the computer, which controls all the other elements of the computer, right? How the instructions comes from the input devices, how it is managed, how it is processed in a CPU, how to send it to the output devices, everything is done by the CPU, right? And the main function is the processing. Right, it's a processing device. And then disk drive, a peripheral device that reads or writes information on a disk. Right, a disk drive is what? It reads the whatever information reads or written or the is copied on it, whatever data is there on it. Right, so disk drive means CD drive. This DVD writer and all these are right. Okay, disk drive. Now next is hard drive, a drive usually within the computer case that reads and writes information including the operating system, program files and data files. When we work on computer, whatever things we store, suppose we are storing any movie in our computer, then it will be stored inside a hard disk. It is a permanent kind of memory. Let's talk about memory. So if you talk about memory is divided into two parts, right? First is the primary memory, second is the secondary memory. Primary memory means RAM, ROM, right? RAM and ROM. And secondary memory is hard disk. So whenever you save anything, so here the hard disk is the permanent memory. Okay, this is the permanent one. Permanent memory. Whatever we store in our computer is stored inside this hard disk. Right? If you are storing any movie, any file, any song. Or RAM, whenever you open any, suppose you are working on some software or you are playing games on computer. So that software, suppose you are playing games, so that game will be open at that particular instant of time at this RAM. RAM, random access memory. This is temporary memory, right? And ROM is where the this is read only memory. And suppose you are load the operating system or the things which is that can be only read or some kind of thing here on. Mainly it is for operating system you can consider, right? System related information are kept there in the ROM. Okay, so I hope you understood this. What is CPU? What is disk drive? What is hard drive? Now keyboard. Keyboard is the most common input device using which we give input to the computer, right? Keyboard, mouse, and then scanner, then this barcode reader, optical mark reader, optical character recognizer, light pen, joystick. All these are input devices, right? In which all these are input devices, but keyboard is the most common input device. Okay. Now next is modem. Modem. Wait, I'll tell you what is modem. First, this is a system, right? This is our computer. So in our computer, we give instructions, right? Using the keyboard, mouse. So the devices through which we give instructions to the computer. Wait. This is a computer. And here we give instructions to the computer, and then computer after processing it gives the output. So the devices through which we give instructions to the computer are known as the input devices, and the devices through which we can see the output are known as the output devices. Take care now. Or this is the processing device like that of the CPU. So input, processing, output. Okay, so input devices are, what are the input devices? Most common one is the keyboard. Most common one is the keyboard, then mouse, then scanner, then joystick, then light pen, and barcode reader, optical character recognizer. All these are the number of devices are there, right? Mic is also considered as an input device, because whatever we are speaking, it goes first inside the system, right? And what are all the output devices? Monitor, right? Monitor, then speaker, then printer, all these are output devices, okay? And this number of output devices are there, right? So input, processing, output. I hope you understood. Now next, modem. Modem is a kind of device which is used for internet connectivity. Suppose this is your computer and you want to connect with a broadband, so modem will be there, right? Using the modem, using telephone lines, you can have internet connection on your PC. So a peripheral device used to connect one computer to another over a phone line. Okay, so modem. Internet is what? It's a kind of network. It is helping you to connect your system to a network, right? So this is it. Modem is a device which is used to connect you to number of systems. That is in the part of internet. The next is monitor. Monitor means what? Monitor, this is the output device through which we see the output visual display, right? A device used to display information visually. Whatever data we have given as an instructions, it is processed by the system and the output can be seen through the monitor, right? It's a mouse is an input device. We have already seen mouse. In mouse, we have left click, right click, scroll button, right in the center, and through the double click also we can give the instructions. So the different kinds of click event is there. Keyboard buttons are pressed and mouse are clicked to give an instruction. And NIC, network interface card, a board inserted in a computer that provides a physical connection to a network, right? You have seen that in network interface card, right? This is used for internet connectivity or LAN connection, right? Network internet fast, NIC card, NIC card, okay? Next is printer. Printer is an output device. It's a peripheral device that converts output from a computer into a printed image. So we have given a printer is what? Suppose any kind of sheet or something is there, a soft copy of some kind of instruction or something is there, which can be converted into hard copy in a paper. We can take it in the printout of the paper, something on a paper. So it's a hard copy. So soft copy to hard copy conversion in case of printer. So that's why it is output device. Or in case if it is some device is converting hardware to software, then it is a scanner kind of device, right? Hardware to software. Understood? Now next, let's see this. So computer is divided into two parts, hardware and software. The second one is the software. Hardware, we have seen all these devices we have discussed just now, all hardware devices. Now let's see what are softwares. So softwares, we can see the those parts of computer which we cannot touch, right? All we can see, it is a set of instructions, or we can see instructions executed by a computer, right? So the same thing can be defined in number of ways. So application, complete self-contained program that perform a specific function. Let me tell you that software are what? Set of instructions which is executed by the computer. But these are also of two types. One is system software. System software means computer, right? So system software means computer software. And one is application software. What is the difference between these two? System software and application software. System software are those softwares which is used to run the system, execute the system. System is working because of it only. Without this, system cannot work. And application softwares are those softwares in which we work for our purpose, for doing some particular task, like MS Word, MS PowerPoint. MS PowerPoint, we are using it for creating some presentation. Paint software, we are using to draw something, right? Or paint something. Or the in Excel, we are going to do some kind of accounting work. So these are all softwares we are using for some particular task of ours. That's why these are all application softwares. And system softwares is operating system. Getting operating system, like that of Windows operating system, Linux, all these are system softwares. But getting, so remember this. Now, so applications means you understood application software, right? Complete self-contained program that performs a specific function like spreadsheet or database. A spreadsheet means MS Excel, database means we can consider example as a MS Access. And bit, a computer most basic unit of information. We know computer understands 0 and 1, right? So 0, 1, all these are bits. So 0, 1, 0, 1 combination is what? 1 byte, we consider 1 byte, right? 1 byte means 8 bits. So 8 bits means 8 combination of 0 and 1, right? Okay, so this is 1 bit, this is 1 bit, this is 1 bit, this is 1 bit. These are 4 bits, right? 4 bits is considered as 1 nibble, and 8 bits are considered as 1 byte, right? This is the basic information which is stored in a computer, in a digital information system. We call it as a binary information. Okay, a computer's most basic unit of information is a bit. Boot. Boot is what? Booting we call, you have heard this term booting. Booting means when you switch on your computer, some processes is performed on some on your computer and then it starts. And after some time it will be ready for you to use it. Okay. So that time in which you wait for the system to start, that process is called booting. Means in that time operating system is loaded on your computer. The process of loading or initializing an operating system on a computer usually occurs as soon as the computer is turned on. Okay. Now next is browser. What is browser? Mozilla, Firefox, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer. Suppose I ask you to open some page on internet. So what you will do first? You will open Google Chrome, Mozilla, Firefox, or the Internet Explorer. And then in that you will write some kind of domain name or you'll find something on Google. So what is it? So this softwares in which you do browsing or open some web pages are known as the browser. Okay, browser is a special software or program in which you can access web pages or internet pages, right? Now next is bug. A part of computer program that is usually causes the computer to malfunction. Bug means error, right? Virus kind of thing, what they do? They harm our system due to which you are unable to work properly on your system. So they are considered as a bug. If your system will not work properly, right? A part of program. Infectious program you can call, right? Like that of virus and all. They are all bugs. A part of computer program that usually causes the computer to malfunction, often remedies in patches or update to the program. Okay. A byte, I already told you. 8 bits equal to 1 byte. Okay. A small unit of data storage, 8 bits usually holds 1 character. Okay. Click. Using mouse, you click and give the instructions. Right. That is click. Database. Database is as a set of data in a structured manner. Database softwares you have heard, right? Suppose I want to store the collection of the data of the students of our school. So I will use to keep it in a database. So the records of all the students will be kept inside database. So that is a database. Database, you can see, is a kind of software in which we can maintain the records of the organization or something, right? Large amount of data can be stored, and this software is in such a way so that we can easily access, we can easily manage, right? A large structured set of data, a file that contains numerous records that contain numerous fields, and always remember, in database records are maintained in the form of data are maintained in the form of tables, right? Diskette, a small flexible disk used for storing computer data, right? Double click is also the function in our mouse through which we give instructions, right? Single click, double click. Download means if you download any file from the internet, okay, you are downloading something, some kind of music and all. So that is the download. Upload means if you are uploading something on the internet, you are you know, you are having some kind of file on your system and you are putting it on internet so that number of people can access it online. That is uploading. And suppose somebody has kept it online and you are downloading it, then you are putting it separately on your system, then it is downloading. Okay. Drag means what? Drag means if you are dragging one file, suppose one file is here and I will put it here. So if from my mouse I will click it, and holding the mouse I will and left click, I will drag it. That is holding the left click, I will drag it to somewhere else. That is the dragging. Okay, dragging of folder files. Drivers, our mouse is working, our keyboard is working, different kind of printer is also attached to our system. So this printer is also, when it is attached, we install the driver of that printer also, right? So there are a number of drivers so that the number of this external devices can function, can be executed with your system, can be attached to your system, can perform. So what are all this? They are known as drivers. So software program that controls a piece of hardware or a peripheral. Take the example of a printer. Okay, when you attach a printer, you install that the software of that printer, then only it will work, right? Then only you will be able to take the printer from that system. Understood? So these are all you know, the basic terminologies which we must know in our day-to-day life, right, related to our IT or computer. So that's it for today. Thank you and nice day.